In this video, we're reviewing the Tower Hobbies CutBack. Hey everyone, I'm Nate.
And I'm Abby.
We are the RC Sailors, and we're reviewing the Tower Hobbies CutBack. I want to start with the fact that this has Tower Hobbies 1 year bash-proof guarantee warranty. That means that any plastic parts that break on this short course truck in the first year that you own it, they will replace, no questions asked.
That's awesome.
That's amazing.
And just so you all know, we have not broken a single thing on this.
We've been very hard on this truck. And if you don't believe us, look at it now.
And go watch our mudding video.
And go watch all the videos. Every single one, it's taken a beating. And there have been a few hard hits off camera too. We've got a few dents and dings in the body, just a little bends and scratches. But beyond that, there are no damaged parts on this. On top of that, if you're a Tower Super Saver Club member, they'll double that 1 year warranty to a full 2 years of a bash-proof guarantee on this amazing short course truck. So you would think a warranty like that would make this like $100 more than most short course trucks on the market, but that's not the case. It's actually $300 on Tower's website
right now,
full retail value, which is a great intro price. It's got a ton of power in the motor. It runs on a 3600 kV four-pole brushless motor. And we run our LiPo batteries in this truck, which is a huge plus.
It makes it very powerful with how it comes stock.
Right. We personally like to run Onyx 5000 milliamp 2-cell batteries in the Tower Hobbies AlloyForce CutBack.
Not Ally.
Right.
Refer to our unboxing video to understand that. The AlloyForce CutBack.
Whoa, all right. It does come completely ready to run, except for a battery and a charger, which is pretty common. If you're just getting into the hobby, again, we recommend Onyx 5000 milliamp LiPo batteries to sell with Deans connectors because this came Deans ready, which I absolutely love. And Onyx makes a great charger that we really like too. This does run on a 2.4 gigahertz transmitter. The transmitter, I do think it's worth noting that it's a nice transmitter. It feels a lot like Axial's transmitters or really most good ready to run transmitters for ground vehicles that are on the market now. There's nothing bad I can say about it. It's got all the trims that you need right on the transmitter. The battery life is amazing. We haven't had to change batteries since we've owned it. It's very ergonomical and very comfortable. The antenna folds down. The trims are underneath the pop-up tab there. Abby's showing you. Pretty straightforward.
And it features Tower Hobbies logo, of course. I think it feels good. And it has a nice squishy.
This truck weighs 6 pounds, and that's because it's not all metal. Underneath, you can see a full aluminum plate. I'm probably dropping a bit of dirt on the table.
And dirt and leaves. We've had fun with it.
This helps increase the durability quite a bit by having this 3 millimeter aluminum plate on the bottom. It also makes it quite a bit heavier. Heavier means it sticks to the track better. We've driven this on a short course track just for fun, not for
a short course track. Oh yeah.
We did.
Well, was that? I think that's more considered a buggy track.
It's a short course track. It was a racetrack. It was a dirt racetrack that we drove it on for fun, mainly bashing, but it handled the curves really well. It stuck to the dirt. It did what it was supposed to do, and that's without any modifications. Mm-hmm. So if you were to mod this, I'm sure it would just own the course.
I did a stinking flip with this thing.
That was awesome.
On the track. This on is, the track. We're gonna cut to that right now.
Let's just go ahead and talk about the looks of the truck, because personally, I really like the color scheme. I really like blue and black together.
I like the color combination of the dark royal blue and the light, like, Robin's egg blue, I don't know.
The black on this has a nice print to it. It's made to look like carbon fiber, which is really neat. Mm-hmm. They even went as far as putting the stickers on the little fan ports there to make sure it looked like it had fans. Now that she turned the back of that around, I want to make sure I point out the fact that it has true rubber mud flaps.
And they have been used.
Right.
Very well.
I
love
those. I'd kind of like to see how much dirt it could kick up without the mud flaps, but they look awesome. It brings a bit of scale to it, and it's just a lot of fun to have the mud flaps on the truck. The front of it looks great too. It's got really nice sticker decals for the headlights. We've banged into very hard objects and scratched things and gone through mud and ripped things across it, and we have
rocks dirt and grass,
everything.
And
we haven't had any of the decals start to come off yet. Again, it doesn't look like it, but I've power washed this before our last bashing, and through the hose power washing, it didn't want to peel any of these stickers off, so they did a good job putting those on. I think we really should look under the body now. So these clips are pretty heavy duty.
They're
stronger than some other body clips we've had.
And they're not
the channel.
Curved up, so it makes it...
They're a little hard to punch off of here. I like to get my pocket knife and just push on the clip. It's pretty easy to take off once you've done that, but they're heavy duty clips, and that's good, because you don't want these things popping off while you're driving. We've lost clips while driving RCs before, and that's no fun to lose parts. The drive shaft underneath the body here is steel. They're not plastic, and there's a lot more metal underneath. That's what I want to show you guys. Keep in mind.
And a lot more dirt.
We do need to clean this.
So, where do you want to start, babe? I'm embarrassed.
Again, it does have the hardened steel drive
shafts.
This
is like when people come to your house and your house is still dirty. That's what I feel like.
This is how you drive an RC.
The antenna, I want to point out, because sometimes placement of antennas frustrates me if it's in a poor place. I like where this is. It's hidden under the body while you're driving, so no antennas are sticking out, and it doesn't get bent or anything. It's really nice. Let's go. Battery placement is nice on here, and there's nothing really super bad about it or anything. Your battery's not so much protected unless you have a battery like we prefer. Again, these Onyx batteries that are in a hard pack. Just Velcro's in here. There's two straps of Velcro that hold it on.
And in my opinion, it was kind of hard to get it in there. And once you had the battery in there, it was pretty hard. Like if you took those straps out, once the battery was in, it was pretty hard to get that back in.
Okay.
That's what I thought.
If you pull the strap all the way through. Okay, fair enough. The ESC is advertised as being waterproof, and I think it is, I agree. The mounts for the body, which are also connecting to the entire body of the car, and the shocks are aluminum, so there's another nice hard aluminum piece, 3 millimeters, underneath the body. That steering servo that I pointed out earlier is waterproof. It's also got metal gears in the steering servo, so that's really nice because it's going to be a lot harder to strip your steering servo. This thing has a lot of torque. It really kicks when you give it the gas right from the get-go. It doesn't twist or bind when you're giving it gas. That's really important when you're racing because you're not having to counter that or trim that out. The rear bumpers, well, the rear and forward bumpers take hits really well. They protect the body, which is protecting your entire RC truck.
And it doesn't hurt too bad when it hits you, right, Nate?
I've been hit by this, yeah. I don't know. It's got weight to it and it's fast. It'll get the ankles pretty good. You do need to be careful when you're driving this. The range on the shock of the tire, here we go. There's about, this is the full range. It's got great range. Just look at some of the slow motion video we have of this racing and ramping around, and you can really see this in action. The run time is probably about 40 to 50 minutes, even when we're running it really hard on our 5,000 milliamp Onyx batteries. And the charge time really depends on your charger, but we can get them charged in about an hour or less, usually no more than an hour. Mm-hmm. So that's a really good trade-off when you're racing around something this powerful and this fast, if you can get a run time that's almost the same as your charge time. Pick a few batteries up, take this out on the course, and you'll have fun all day. Personally, I think the most important factor of this hobby is whether or not it's fun. And I think we both really try to stick to that. This truck truly is fun, in my opinion. I've had nothing but fun driving this when I drove it, not having to worry about parts breaking, and just enjoying it.
But I mainly drove it.
Right, yeah, this is... it's kind of your truck. You've almost inherited this as your truck. So what do you think? I mean, is it?
I love it. It's the best ground vehicle I've ever driven. It's probably one of my favorites. It's very versatile and a very well-rounded vehicle. You can take it on pretty much any surface and it's going to do great. So that says a lot.
Stock is how we review our vehicles, and stock, it's a blast.
It was very impressive.
Abby and I really like this truck. I think we would recommend it to someone just getting into the hobby or looking for your first short course truck because it's extremely durable. And when it's not durable, it's got a warranty to back it up. That's it. I mean, the Tower Hobbies Cutback, the AlloyForce Tower Hobbies Cutback.
AlloyForce.
This is a great hobby to be into, guys. It's supposed to be fun, so buy this and have fun with it. Let us know how your first few bashes go. Please, if you make mods to it, I want to see it on our Facebook page. So stop by the Facebook page.
Facebook.com/RCSaylors with a Y.
Right. And share your pictures with us. We sincerely thank you all for watching.
And we want to thank Tower Hobbies and Hobby Co. for sponsoring this video.
Thank you very much. We'd like to invite you over to our channel to watch our challenge series because we give away free monthly RC products, usually vehicles.
Always vehicles.
Yeah, so far. It's a lot of fun. We just challenge each other and you just vote for me or her and you'll be entered in to win our giveaway. Make sure you stop by towerhobbies.com, get the cutback. It's $300. Look for promo codes. You can get it even cheaper a lot of times. Let us know how your first few bashes go, and we will see you in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching, guys.
Bye, this is awesome. One look bash. At all these leaves that I pulled out while we were sitting here.